Hello everybody, Mr. Max Dom 1, how y'all doing? I'm back out with you with a versus is why I bought this 2022 Hayabusa versus other bikes, especially the 2022 Kawasaki ZX1400. The first thing I want to say is that the color of the bikes, Suzuki has three different color combinations that you can choose from compared to Kawasaki's one color of their ZX1400. That was the first thing. The other thing was the technology in this bike, specifically all the multiple, the quick shifter, the traction control, the lean angle, the brake percentages and stuff like that. This new Suzuki Hayabusa has more technology and better built than the new Kawasaki ZX1400. Saying all that, even though this bike actually cost more in certain ways, I actually did feel pretty bad. I actually felt better sitting on the 2022 Kawasaki 1400. With the technology and the lean angle and some of the stuff, I decided to go towards this 2022 Hayabusa. There are some things I'm going to be posting that are going to be doing some upgrade modifications to this bike. It's not going to be much. As you can probably see, compared to the one I've posted yesterday, I did add a center post phone mount. Let's see if you can see. Right there. So, hold on. Get my key in here. Now, one of the things, I'm gonna sit right here, that I don't like is that when I'm down on the handlebars, the visor kind of cuts into the speedometer and everything a little bit. Where on the Kawasaki, it was more up this way, so it was, the cluster was so much clearer. So that's going to be one of the changes I'm going to be doing, is the visor. I actually just received it in the mail. And when I take this one off, I want to compare this one to the other one. By ordering it, they basically said that it was supposed to be an OEM, and it's supposed to be a rise of 38 millimeters, which basically comes out just shy of 1.5 inches. So I'm hoping that this bubble here will be up just 1.5 inches, which will definitely make it easier to see the instrument cluster as you're riding. And I got something else supposed to be receiving in the mail today. So we are gonna set this thing down. And the reason why I haven't been doing any riding is because when I bought the bike and had it delivered, the day after, you're supposed to be getting some snow. So I spent all my time, once the bike was delivered, it pretty much set. And now got so much gravel and stuff like that on the road right now. So I've had this bike for about 3 weeks, and I haven't gone anywhere on it yet, and I'm anxious to get there, but I figured since I'm waiting around that I do some modifications and some upgrades. So I'll go ahead and talk to you about some of the stuff that I already got when I got the bike. So first thing was, when I got the bike, it was getting a tank protector, and I didn't like the ones that they had, and the ones that were supposed to be for this bike, they only had two colors, which was red and gold, and they didn't really have one that really matched the bike. And so I kind of went with the gold, because the fact that, well, the sales guy said, well, you know, probably go with the gold, since the fact that you got the gold here, the gold over here. And I was like, you know what, that's actually not a bad idea. That actually matches, you know, it's not like it's going to be out of place. So that was one of the first mods that I did and had them put on. And there's a few other things that I had it on, added on, but I'm not going to mention what they are. But like I said, I got the phone mount added on, for, you know, so I can have a cell phone. The other mount, or let's see what else. Yeah, it's not, yeah, I mean, that was another reason why I got this one, because it was white, and every place I found, they either had the black and gold, they had the silver and red, and this one was hard to find, and I finally found it, and I got it for a cheap price. And, yeah, but like I said, it still kind of came over the price of, the Kawasaki ZX1400. So that was kind of the battle of trying to determine, it's like, okay, well, do I get one that's got more technology for a few hundred dollars more, or do I save that few hundred dollars and get one that still has the analog and nothing updated, and it's only got one color choice? And so I was like, you know what? I was like, I'm a Suzuki guy, so I was like, you know, I want to do the Suzuki. And so that's the reason why I got the Suzuki. You know, because all the upper technology that's on this bike, and you know, the multiple different color choices that you have. And I think another thing was, is that, because normally with a Suzuki, you got to hold the clutch in, and you have to hold the start button down for about, you know, a couple seconds. But with this one, this has got the quick start on it. So you don't have to hold the clutch in, just push the button and it'll start. It's great. And just the different functions and functionality. And plus the way I've been riding, I've been spending more time riding on the highway. So I think it was time for me to get something, more of a tour. So that's the reason why I went with this. I do have my other one. I have the Victory Cross Country that I bought, but that's strictly touring, you know, and I wanted something that still had that ability to be a sports bike. So I wanted something that was a sport touring, so that's what the Honda, or the Hayabusa is for. Like I said, I'm going to be making some more videos. This is going to be probably the second one. The first one was the unveiling, which was kind of a cheapo kind of video. But, you know, hey. But this one's going to just give you a versus why I chose this one. And then I'll have a couple more for upgrades and what I'm choosing for upgrades and how I'm doing with those. So, like this video. Hit the like button. If you're not a Forever Like fan, hit that Forever Like button. And ride safe, be safe, and peace.